people, it's the one and only DJ Malone. I gotta get that fixed because you're not on Malone's Pipeline. That was a show that we did a while back ago, when, you know, I was doing my own thing and on the internet and stuff like that. But today, you're on Chi-Town Urban Radio. And I got these two guys, and you know what I'm saying? And, you know, I love giving you guys the freshest people, the hottest artists around the globe. And today is no exception. Today, we got the foundation into the building. Let's bring them in right now. What's going on, man?
What's going on, man?
Yo, what's the deal? Foundation.
What's going on?
DJ Malone.
Man, well, welcome. Oh, man, I'm chilling, man. Welcome to the show.
Appreciate you. Happy to be here. Thanks for having us.
Definitely, man. Well, let's talk about it. Let's talk about the foundation. Let's talk about this. So, where did it all begin and where did it start?
Well, you know, it all began in New Jersey. That's where we're from. You know what I'm saying? East Orange, Naperville. But, you know what I'm saying? The beginning of the movement started out here in North Carolina, Greensboro. You know what I mean? One summer night, you know what I'm saying? And then it took off from there. It took on a life of its own.
Yeah, man. It was something that, you know, we just put our mind to it. And then that was it.
Look,
you feel me? You go somewhere mentally and you never come back from it.
Yeah,
and that's what happened.
Shit kind of like chose us in a sense, you know what I'm saying? Because we was into, you know what I mean, a couple other things, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, but we here now, and you know what I'm saying? It's Alleyway to Broadway, we here on, you know what I'm saying? DJ Malone.
So, Alleyway to Broadway is the movement.
Yeah.
It's the song, it's the movement, that's what it is. Before we go any further, I know this two of you, but I want the people to get to know. So tell the people who you are individually.
Okay, I'll go first and shit. Well, I'm Mal Casso. You know what I'm saying? I'm younger bro. A move smoother. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna let him go. Yeah, I'm move smoother. Yeah, move smoother, dog. You know what I'm saying? Whatever you want to call it. You know what I mean? I'm the older brother. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, we Broadway ENT. My other man, like, Big A, Chief A&R Broadway ENT. You know what I'm saying? So we also the label also. You know what I mean? But, yeah, that's us individually. You know what I mean?
Real. That's what it is, then, man. I like that. So where did you guys come up with the name The Foundation?
Ah, man, that shit, that's a crazy look, you know what I'm saying? But all actuality, I mean, it sounds cliche, but you know what I'm saying? That shit just came to me, you know what I mean? Like, because we wasn't even going by no name at first, you know what I'm saying? We was just going individually and we was just doing our thing, even though we brothers. That sounds like kind of crazy, but you know what I'm saying? We was just, you know what I mean, in the studio, going by individual names. We really didn't need to go with it. And then one night, you know what I'm saying, when I'm just writing, you know what I'm saying, writing some lyrics to this, you know, joint that we was working on. And that shit just came to me from there, man. Like, for real. Like, that shit just dropped in my head. Like, I stopped writing and everything. And then I ran it by him. I'm like, yo, what you think about that? What you think about going by that, like, as a group name? And he liked it, that shit. You know what I'm saying? And then from there, that was it.
Okay, definitely. Try not to curse so much because we are on AM 16A and I don't want the FA to come after us and, you know, that ain't
good. My bad.
You good. But yeah, okay, so that's what it is. That's what it is. I like to hear stories like that, how people come together and, you know, two heads are better than one. So let me ask you this. Who are some of you guys' inspirations?
Come on. I mean, like, you know, well, first of all, we inspire each other. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know, most movement, that's one of my biggest inspirations. You know what I'm saying? You know, my family, you know, my pops, my moms, you know what I'm saying? You know? But, you know, like, when it comes to, like, musically-wise, you know, you got the guys like the Jay-Z and, you know, Max B. And that's it. That's about it.
That's real.
Jay and Max, that's about it.
Yeah.
Too many Jada Kiss, you know, Styles P, you know, you can always, but everybody know those, like, you know what I'm saying? You know, those really ain't, you know what I mean? But,
the real
but, I mean, well, so we try to, you know, we keep, it's really more foundation, man. Like, it's like we really locked in and in tune with each other and really do. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, yeah, we got a lot of inspiration. We do tune into the music that's out there. But really, man, it's really just foundation, man. We just vibe off each other. Like, we don't try to, you know, make no music that sound like the music that's out there. You feel me? We stay in our own lane and we just make this music, man. Like, as you can hear, man, everywhere to Broadway. You know what I'm saying? We got the loud and clear. You feel me? Money never sleeps. That's a solid project, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, Moneyball, that's a solid project. You feel me? So
it got its own sound.
We got our own sound. You know what I'm saying? So, like, you know, it's wavy. It's wavy, right? You know what I mean?
Yeah. Let's talk about the project, man. Let's talk about first, I want to talk about the alleyway to Broadway, the one that we're promoting, the one that's been spinning everywhere. It's been spinning on 88.9 FM, people, Chi-Town of Radio, Fleet DJ Radio. It's been all over the place. It's catching on. So, I mean, with the alleyway to Broadway, how did you guys come up with that? Was that just something that was planned, or how did you guys come up with that trip?
Well, when we had, you know what I'm saying, had to come up with, you know, Alleyway to Broadway was a title, you know what I'm saying? So it became a movement, you know what I'm saying, through that song, you know what I mean? And it really just was, you know, Dries played the beat, you know what I mean? That's our in-house producer, you know what I'm saying? Shout out Dries Productions. He played the beat and it went from there, man. It just, that was it, you know what I mean? We was already screaming Alleyway to Broadway on everything, so when it came to the, it wasn't like we was like, all right, we need an anthem. It just came together in the studio, you know what I mean? And the movement and the beat, it was just, you know, it was just something unique that happened, and then we just turned it into a track, man.
Real magical, man.
Yeah, that's basically what it was. It wasn't like we were saying we needed an anthem. It was just that it just came out like that.
Yeah.
Because that was the movement, and we were so in tune with what, we were so locked in on the movement. And you know what I'm saying? The whole Alleyway to Broadway type of life, and we was felt like we was living that lifestyle, you know what I mean? So, yeah, you know, we feel like we're still living that. And we still got a ways to go, but you know what I mean? We on our way.
Okay, definitely. This is just a DJ question because, like I said, I am a DJ. How are you guys promoting it and marketing it to the other, I guess, to the other DJs or to the other markets and stuff? How are you guys going about promoting the song?
A lot of submissions. You know, we're blogging it. We post it up on a couple of, you know, like breakingtracks.com. You know what I'm saying? And we're dealing with, shout out DJ XXL, you know what I'm saying? Playing a nice little key role in helping us distribute the song through the Fleet DJ channels. Yourself, you know, DJ Malone, you know what I mean? DJ RL, you know. So we're just basically networking with the DJs, man, because that's who's going to play the music. That's who's going to get it played. We're networking through them, you know what I mean? You know, just Facebook, you know, as much Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, you know what I'm saying, that we can do on our own, you know what I mean, that's cost efficient because we are running a business. So, you know, just a lot of networking with the DJs and trying to get in tune with the DJs and building some relationships, key relationships, you know.
That's what I like to hear. That's what I like to hear. Because a lot of artists I talk to, Joe, they don't do that. And they feel like, oh, well, I'm the hottest thing in the world, but then you have no DJs backing you. So at the end of the day, you got to have the support from at least a few of these DJs who can really be your foot soldiers and play that record.
Yeah. Right.
With that being said, go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, y'all going to play the record. Y'all on the radio, y'all in the clubs, you know, people listen to what y'all listening to, you know what I mean? So, and then a lot of the times y'all airing in one place, but y'all airing in different places and different dates, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? You might be in, you know, St. Louis, same program, same everything, and it's airing in St. Louis, though, you know what I mean, just for an example. So the DJs is a key, it's key, you know what I'm saying? So we learned that, and everybody got to, you know, they go through a growth process, you know what I'm saying? A lot of artists got to go through that growth process where they got to realize that there's no way around this, you know what I mean? And we went through that, and, you know, we here now, you know?
Definitely.
And we dealing with like one of the heavy hitters itself, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to DJ. Yeah, man.
Oh, man. Hey, I'm just here, man. I'm here talking to you guys, man. I feel like there is something big here. And I'm not just saying this is to blow smoke, but I feel like, you know, I listen to the Loud and Clear, the FYI, and, you know, those joints are real lyrical, and they really say something. They have substance to it. So with your music, would you guys say you're more of a lyrical versus to maybe, I don't want to say race from, because I'm no knock to them. I like their hustle, but how would you describe your sound?
I mean, we nothing like them. Nah, first of all. So, we nothing like them.
Out of everybody, every group that we could be compared to, that was never one of them.
Yeah,
no.
That was never one
of them. It's been a lot of the old groups.
Yeah, like Daz Effect. We got compared to them, Mobb Deep. You know what I'm saying? We got we get compared to people.
EPMD.
Like, yeah, EPMD.
I
can
hear Wu-Tang somewhere in there, too. I can hear Wu-Tang.
Yeah.
Definitely shout out to Wu-Tang, you know what I'm saying? Definitely follow.
But I think just because we write, you know what I'm saying, like, for real. And we read.
Yeah.
We have intellectual conversations about, you wouldn't guess, you know what I'm saying, where it could go, you know what I'm saying? Like, so with that being said, when we write in, we try to write about something, or we try to, you know what I'm saying, use some type of terminology that, you know what I'm saying, that you could relate to, but you ain't going to hear it in no everyday artist rhymes. Or you might hear it, but it might not be, it's calibers to it. It's like, it's levels to this, you know what I'm saying? So that's how we just try to be. We just try to say something. We just not about to just put random words together. You know what I'm saying? It won't fit right with our spirit. You know what I'm saying? So that's just what we try to do.
Definitely music with substance, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's what it is. It's foundation
music, man.
Definitely. When you guys hear your songs being played on the radio, or, you know, it's, you know, you're hearing it on the radio, it may be online or FM or wherever it's being played at, what's the feeling that you guys get from that?
Yo, that's amazing, man.
Yeah.
That's amazing. That's what we work hard for.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like, that's what we work hard for, man. Like, we put in a lot of work, man. And the simple press play. Like, you know what I'm saying? Just the simple press play. You feel me? That junk feels amazing to hear you being broadcasted and coming through them airwaves, man.
Yeah.
And knowing that there's some people out there that's hearing. You know what I'm saying? That
don't know you
and might love it just as much as you do. You know what I'm saying? Appreciate it. You feel me? Because, you know, we all about good music, man. You know, but I think it's amazing. I love to hear it. Like, every time. Like, like, I love to hear it. Like,
even though we heard the song mad times already.
Yeah,
it got a different ring to it when we hear it
through the airwaves.
Through the airwaves.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
You know, we ain't never heard.
Yeah, that's the first time. Yeah, it's amazing.
That's real, though. That's real. When you guys perform, let me ask you this. Now, I know sometimes with groups and stuff like that, when I went to go see Wu-Tang in concert, they were on point and everything else like that. And I believe a performance could elevate your artistry as well. So whenever people go to your performances, what are they looking for? What are they seeing?
I mean, they seeing us go to work. They seeing a lot of energy. They seeing a lot of passion. You know what I'm saying? Like, we take a lot of pride in our performance. You know what I'm saying? We don't, you know, we rehearse.
Yeah.
Like, and, you know, we've been rehearsing. You know what I'm saying? It took, you know, shout out to Miss T. You know what I mean? You know, she instilled that in us. She feel me? She came and seen us perform. And, you know, she pulled us off stage. And from there, it was like we was rehearsing and we still rehearse. You feel me? So we take a lot of pride in that, man. And, you know, we come to put on the show.
Yeah.
And really, you know, display our music. You know what I mean? And display our artistry and our personality. You know what I mean? At the same time. You know, like, because we are two different, you know, people. You know what I mean? And you get the Smoova Don and you get Honcho. You know what I mean?
But then when it's like, when they find out that we brothers.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Then they be like, yo. Like, you hear, we hear this a lot. Like, yo, you know what I'm saying? Y'all feed off each other well. And then it's like, you know what I mean? Yeah, we brothers. We're like, oh, real brothers? Yeah, bro, same mother, same father. Like, we same ate out the same kitchen. And they're like,
real,
wow.
Real.
You know what I'm saying? And they can't, and then it's like we could be, and then when we find out that we brothers, and it's like, yo, oh, man. And then it's a whole nother, it's the story from there. And
that's a whole nother playing field.
Yeah, man.
That's a whole nother vibration, energy.
Yeah. Along with the energy that we just gave off.
Yeah.
And then you find out also that goes with it. And it's like, wow. You know what I mean?
Yeah. That's deep, man. With that being said, bro, if you could perform anywhere, where would it be at and why?
Oh, man, I mean,
Madison Square Garden in New York.
Yeah, the Garden.
The Garden, man. That's right home. That's kind of, yep. You know what I'm saying? That's home, you know, New Jersey. I mean, well, it's in New York, but, you know what I'm saying? But Jersey, they go there, you know what I'm saying? Like, people
yeah,
go
yeah,
there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like, not too in far my eyes. Oh, go ahead.
That's not too far-fetched for family to make that show. You know what I'm saying? Like, if we was there. Yeah. And we was... You know, you want to perform back home. You know what I'm saying? But you're talking about doing something... You're talking about something big. You know what I'm saying? Like, you have arrived. You know what I'm saying? Type thing. You know what I'm saying? And to be there when so many people don't walk, grace that stage. And then it not to be that far from home. People from back home to make that trip. You know what I'm saying? And come see you along with everybody else. You know what I'm saying? That's like, that'd be crazy.
That's real. That's love right there, man. Man, we're talking to the foundation right here, people all the way from the East Coast, man. I want you to get in tune with these guys. Notice how I say I want you to get in tune with them. We're here, man, on Sightown of Radio. So, you guys got the alleyway to Broadway, man. What's next for you guys, man? What's upcoming projects you got going on? Where you performing at?
We got FYI coming. That's going to be pretty much going regional. You know what I'm saying? Pretty soon. That's the next project. The next single that we're going to be putting out. You know what I'm saying? We're going to be trying to put some heavy promotion behind that. Far as shows right now, we just, you know what I'm saying, we sitting in the wings right now. We still rehearsing, you know what I'm saying, we ain't really, you know what I mean, every now and then we might grace the stage on an open mic or something like that, but, you know, other than that, you know, we just trying to put all the mental, you know, abilities and the thought into this single, man, and then worry about the shows from there, because we going into markets now, you know what I'm saying, so...
Real.
You know, that said, we just getting everything together, you know what I'm saying? And once it get where it needs to go, you know, then we gonna be talking about booking some shows and, you know, we gonna be in your area. You know what I mean?
You gotta hit me up whenever you guys ever come to Chicago, hit me up. You know, I ain't going nowhere. So but let me ask you this, how do you guys pick your production? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, do you guys already have a group of producers you already work with and know, okay, well, this is something I already know he can go, so he's cool? Or is it like, you know, are you open to, you know, submissions from other producers? And then also, how do you go about choosing the beat? You know, does it talk to you, or how is that beat selection for you?
So, with the producers, Dree's Productions pretty much produced Money Never Sleeps and Moneyball. Like, all our work came from pretty much Dree's Productions so far that we still, you know, playing with right now. You know what I mean? So he's like in-house. We already know exactly what we're getting. And then how that situation happened was, you know what I'm saying, we met him, you know, got his math, and then we linked up. He let us hear something, and it just, it's been a matrimony ever since then. You know what I mean? He got a particular sound, and it's unique. And it's not like, even though he's from the South, it's not like everybody else's that's in the South. It's not like trap beats or, you know, heavy bass beats, you know what I'm saying? Like, things like that is music. He's also a drummer, you know what I'm saying? So he's in the, you know, drums, and he actually, you know what I mean, he's in a band also, you know, so, you know, that sound just came together, man. Like, I'm just, like, for real. You know, you think we, well, I'm not playing, man. When I say it chose us, it really chose us, man. Like, on, you know, been a couple engineers, yeah, but producers, and it come to beats, like, when we got the Drees, it's like we didn't need to look no further. And then Mal, you know, Casso put the, you know, he set the, you know, the, he threw a tweet out there on, you know, social media tips, and we got a lot of beat selections. We got some, you know, like K-Brooks. Shout out K-Brooks. You know, who else that we got in the emails? We got a couple different producers in the email, okay, but K-Brooks is one of the hottest, man.
Yeah, it's a, I mean, the music, man, that junk is how we pick that stuff, man. It's like real on, it's like real unorthodox, like it's like real, like kind of like weird. You know what I'm saying? Cause like Dree's been producing for a minute.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it wasn't like we got the most body of work with him. You know what I'm saying? Like, as you know, like working together, and he worked with a lot of artists. You know what I'm saying? Like, before he met us. Like, and when we met him and we heard his sound and what he had, like, we got the most body of work with this man. You know what I'm saying? Like, so. Like you said, like, yeah, it did chose us, you know what I'm saying? And like, when we found Dree's, it was like, yo,
wow. There was nowhere to look after that.
Yeah, like,
it was, we was right where we needed to be,
and we locked
at the right time, and we boxed in.
Yeah.
And we got those projects done. And we, as you can see,
Every Way to Broadway was recorded in like 2011.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, we riding this wave, and we riding this music, but we riding music that we've been recording. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so, you know, like, it's just, it's all timing, and you gotta put, like, you know, we ain't come from no musical background, man. Like, we learning all of this as we go. You feel me? Like, all of this is new to us. You feel me? Like, we running the label here. You feel me? So, like, you know.
Oh, go ahead. No,
yeah,
I was just about to ask about the label situation. Talk to us about that, you know what I'm saying? Because the business aspect is crazy in this music game. Because if your business is not on point, you're going to fail. It's just inevitable. So, how did, you know, with the label situation, how did you guys go to get in on that?
I mean, you know, it was just like a business decision for us, you know what I'm saying? We wanted to own our own, you know what I mean? Period. So, you know, we started the label, you know what I'm saying? Smoova, he the CEO, I'm the COO, you know what I'm saying? A head of A&R, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, we take care of everything, man. That's just how we doing. Like, we doing everything on our own. Like,
we was looking for distribution. We wasn't really looking to be like, to sign it all the way to somebody.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, we was like, what we want out of this? You know, you got to ask yourself that question. What you want? What you want to do with this? You want to give, you want to work and give it to somebody and they, you know, or do you want this to sustain for generations? And we chose for it to be a situation where we could sustain it for generations. You know what I'm saying? So that's not saying that we wouldn't take a deal in the right situation, because we still got Broadway ENT. You know what I'm saying? So that's always going to be up.
Yeah, regardless.
You know what I mean? Broadway ENT is always going to be ours. The things that we released underneath Broadway ENT is always going to be owned by Broadway ENT. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, if another situation given and it was the right situation and it was beneficial to us, yeah, we would consider it. But, you know, we still try to remain, you know, on our level with our business and our label. And, you know, that's how it just came about. You know, you just got to ask yourself a question and then you go from there. So,
and it's all timing, you feel me? And once you start talking to the right people,
yeah,
you feel me? And networking with the right folks, it's going to take on a life of its own, man. Like, you can't, like, we ain't rushing this. Like, we ain't rushing none of this, bro. Like, we, everything that's happening is happening for you.
Yeah.
Everything that's happening. And it's all timing, and it's great timing. You feel me? As I say,
yeah.
I say, has our timeline, as everything's been happening, and what we've been doing, and the people we've been meeting, and connections, and you know what I'm saying, the conversations we have been in, I think it's great timing. You know what I'm saying? It's like, it's blessing. It's a blessing, man. Like, we still going. Like, it's a blessing that we still going, man. We still able to operate and do this, man. Like, for real, all praise the Most High. You know what I mean? But, you know, we still at it. We still at it.
That's what it is. That's what it is. And I respect when you guys say, I just want the distribution. I always tell, you know, people that they have, like, an independent label or whatever situation is, and a major comes, don't ever sign. Don't ever sign that full deal. Ask for that distribution, because that's going to be crazy. That's the only thing I need from you guys is the distribution.
Yeah, you're right. That's what you really need. You don't need to sign away everything. You know, distribution deals are just as lucrative, if not more.
Exactly.
So we're looking to make some money, and we're looking to, you know, continue to do what we want to do. And our biggest thing was creative control. Like, that's what scared us the most. That was the main thing about not really, like, signing to, like, no major or nothing like that, because that creative control was just one of the things that we just didn't never want to be in a position where somebody can control us, you know, our appearance and, you know, how we look and how we make music and our sound and all of that. That's like, that was one thing that we was never really feeling. So, and that led to a lot of, yo, we need our own label, or, you know what I'm saying, we need to start it, but actually putting it on paper is a whole nother process. And some people got to get to that process. Like, you can have it in your mental, you can write it down and have it on paper, but you got to get that paperwork to follow it, because that's the only thing that they're going to respect is that paperwork.
That's real. That is so real, man, because I got to always be telling these artists who are coming up into the game, and they feel like, oh, well, you know, I don't necessarily have to do that, or they don't know. They don't do the research. In this day of age, I never want to hear a person say, I didn't know. There's too many ways to know. Either YouTube, Google, read a book. You know what I'm saying? There's too many different ways to say, I never knew.
Yeah.
So, definitely, man. With that being said, man, we're coming down to the nitty-gritty of the interview, but I got a couple more questions to ask you guys. Who would you like to work with, as far as artist-wise? Who would you like to work with going into the future?
I mean, I don't know. It's two of us already. So, you know, you don't get too many groups that do features, so...
Yeah.
I mean, if we had to pick, like, a maybe, like, an R&B singer, I'd say maybe, like, Chris Brown, Keisha Cole. I think a Chris Brown feature would be dope. And maybe a Keisha Cole feature also. Probably like a, you know, I don't know. Maybe, I don't know. You know, it all depends, man. It all depends, man.
That's real. Okay. Yeah, that's what it is, then. What producer?
I mean,
would
whatever,
you like
whatever is meant to happen will happen. Wow. Like, you feel me?
We got a future with just juice.
Yeah, whatever's meant to happen will happen. You know what I'm saying? When you get in that field and you in that realm and you get around these peoples and you can get to these people and these people can get to you. You know what I'm saying? Whatever manifests will manifest. You know what I'm saying? So it's all time.
That's real. What about producers?
Producers, oh man, I would love to work with like Swiss Beats, Zaytoven. Man, who is
it? Just Blaze, hopefully.
Oh yeah, Just Blaze.
Dame Grease.
Yeah, man, it's a lot of
Dre,
DJ Mustard.
Yeah.
Producer.
Who else? What's that? Metro.
Metro Boomin.
Yeah.
One.
Metro Boomin.
Something like that. Yeah, man. It's a lot of producers.
It's even some underground producers.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
They ain't even got to be no mainstream producers, man.
Yeah.
It's a lot of underground producers out here that's like, they got some heat, man.
Yeah, yeah, like Chop House.
Yeah. Hey, you know what, though? Jeez. I really like him for some reason. I really do like him.
Who's that?
Trap House.
Chop House?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I like him. He's dope. Well, yeah, man. Okay. Well, let me ask you this. What advice could you give to somebody that's coming into this game? Like, you know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people, they want to be rappers. Everybody wants to be a rapper these days. So what advice could you give to them, you know, starting their career and stuff like that?
Man, rapping, and that's just... I guess, of course, your performance is supposed to, you got to make sure your performance is on point, but it's 90% business, man. Research, you know what I'm saying? Do your homework on stuff, man. Like, do your homework.
And don't take it personal.
Nah, don't take it personal. Don't take it personal.
Everybody's not going to like everything that you do. People are going to have their opinions. People are going to have their criticism. But don't take it personal. Get over it. You got to be like an NFL player, the next play. You know what I'm saying? You mess up one play, all right, that was first down. Second down is a whole nother play, a whole nother chance to right the wrongs, a whole nother chance to make it happen. So that's what you got to do. You got to get over it quick. Because if you dwell on it, it'll mess with you creatively. You won't be able to write. You won't be able to think because you're thinking about something that somebody else said that you might never run into again. When you could just perfect it. You know what I mean? Perfect whatever you got going on. All right, bet. I'm going to work harder. I'm going to get my style. I'm not changing nothing. I'm going to just perfect what I got. You know what I'm saying? You keep it moving. And just keep it moving, man. But don't take it personal, man. That's it. You can only quit. Only person that could quit for you is you. And a lot of people quit because of what other people said. You know what I'm saying? Other people told them that they couldn't do this, couldn't say that, couldn't write that, won't be able to do this, X, Y, Z. And they gave it up. Or, you know what I'm saying? And that's when every aspect in life. Even when somebody want to be like, what? You know what I'm saying? You want to open up your own business, your boutique or something. Somebody, you know what I'm saying? It's just every aspect in life. Don't take it personal. Keep it moving. Everybody's going to have an opinion. You know what I'm saying? So, you got to have tough skin.
Go to the artist, yeah. Man. Network. Network, 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 network.
Yeah, you got to learn that too.
We was never too big for opportunity, man. And I think that got us, to where we at now too, man. We was never too big for opportunity, man. We always gave
you know, everybody a chance, you know, that believed in us, took interest in us, no matter where it was. You know what I mean? So, you know, just be open to things, have an open mind, and, you know, do good business.
Go into situations with good faith. Don't go into a situation thinking that somebody might be BSing you or they really ain't got the plugs that they say they got. You go into everything feeling like, yo, this might be it. This my shot right here. You know what I mean? And you go into that situation with good faith. Until that situation reveals itself for what it really is, then that's when you take it for what it really is. But you go into it with good faith. But you be smart about it. You know what I'm saying? Don't just give somebody all your bread. Or don't just tell everybody, don't give them the keys to the house. You know what I'm saying? But you go into that situation feeling like, this could be the situation that takes me to the next level. You know?
Real.
And you got option A, option B, option C. You know? And then if that situation is not what you thought it was, it'll reveal itself in due time. You know?
That's real. I think one thing what I will say before I let you guys go, one thing I will say is I think a lot of people have to understand this, like I told you guys before, research. Ask people about this person. I always go on, if you're spending money with a DJ or a promoter, ask people about that promoter or whoever that you're about to engage with. Because if he's really about this business, his name is going to be somewhere. In the streets, online, somewhere. Somebody has worked with this guy to get his, to get that reputation to where it's good. So, that's all I got to say about that.
That's real.
But let's give it to Facebook and Twitter, everything where they can find you, man.
Yo, man. You could search us on Facebook, The Foundation, DA Foundation. You know what I'm saying? Facebook / The Foundation Music. The Twitter, The Foundation, DA _ Foundation on Twitter. On Instagram is @ Alleyway to Broadway. That's Alleyway to Broadway using the number 2, man. But if you go to the website, you know, alleywaytobroadway.com, man, you got all the links, man. You got our blog, our music. We got some clothes up there, man. We looking to upgrade on our apparel pretty soon. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, man, go to the website. I encourage you to go to the website, alleywaytobroadway.com. You know what I'm saying? It's up and running. We got all the latest, everything up there. You know what I mean? So, you know, there you go.
What it is. Make sure you guys check them out. Alleywaytobroadway.com. Make sure you check them out. Everything. The Foundation, man. Hey, I appreciate you guys coming in and really showing support.
Well, man. Appreciate you, yo, having us on.
Yeah, man. We appreciate everything you're doing for us and the support that you're giving us, too, man. Now on the records, too, man.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. It's love. That's for smart. Me, man. Love for me long way.
Copy that.
So definitely, man. Before you guys go, can I get a drop from you guys, man? You could say this is The Foundation or your individual names or whatever you want to do and say I'm rocking with Chi-Town Urban Radio.
Yo, what's up, man? It's your boy, Mal Casso, and I'm rocking with Chi-Town Urban Radio with the heavy hitter DJ Malone.
What's going on? It's your boy, Move Smoova. We rocking with Chi-Town Urban Radio. DJ Malone, man. What's going on?
Yeah, dick. That's what it is, man. Hey, I appreciate you guys coming in and really supporting your boy.
Definitely, man. Anytime, man.
Definitely. The Foundation, people, alleywaytobroadway.com. That's the best way you could do it. Buy their pill. Make sure you guys get in tune with them. Let's go ahead and get into this real quick. Let it go!
You are in the mix with DJ Malone. Show them how to do it.